Barry, one more time. We've talked to you and we've seen you in the ring all of the time. But now, since all these networks are picked up and now you're part of it, how does it feel to be part of, you know, the announcing process?
It's cool, man. It's, you know, of course it's different, you know, but, you know, I'll just get on there and talk about what I know, and that's boxing, you know what I mean? Al said that, you know, he wanted to put the microphone in my hand, you know, and he did that, and I'm grateful to Al Haymon for that, and, you know, it's just been real nice, man.
Yeah, so do you have to do any, like, studying? You have to study fighters, or you just do what you do?
Oh, no, you know, it's, listen, man, training fighters is easier than, you know, going to this network deal, you know, but, you know, I got good people around me. You know, showing me the ropes, you know what to say, how to say it, and, you know, what not to say, you know. And you know, it's just a whole nother, you know, it's a different realm of work, you know. And, you know, just like I had to study the craft, you know, and I got to study this, man.
You know, and you were Bounce TV, what other work networks you had with you?
I did Fox One Sports, Spike, and I want to say NBC. You know, or it was one of the affiliates, but, okay. You know, of course I worked with Ray Leonard, Mike Mascaro, Steve is, you know, my guy, Brian, Fran, you know, and all these guys, man, you know, just, you know, tremendous of what they do. I got mad respect for what they do, man, because it's definitely not easy, you know. But, you know, they hung with me and, you know, hopefully, you know, I can make them proud.
You know, it's like you said, you've been training and everything. But how do you appreciate everything that you've done from starting with kids as amateurs, coming up to be exactly where you are right now?
You know, a lot of times, Juan, I don't really think about it until, you know, somebody like yourself or, you know, somebody in passing bring it up. And just let me know, you know, how far, you know, that I've actually come, you know, in boxing, you know, through the whole world of boxing. You know, starting off training babies on my knees, you know, working the mitts with them on my knees. Boogie was 18 years old, man, you know, when I first started this thing, man. He's well in his 40s now. And, you know, so much has passed, man. You know, I missed out on a lot, you know, but I got to do a lot, you know, and I made a lot of friends along the way, man.
Yeah, you even had a chance, you know, to work with the Olympic team, you know, and how was that experience?
Work with the Olympians, you know, you look at, you know, when I see, you know, like Andre Ward and Andre Berto, Victor Ortiz was 15 years old. I remember Amir Khan, you know, from the JOs, you know, Andre Anthony Durrell. I mean, let's go on and on. Nonito Donaire. I was with Antonio Tava, you know, we was talking the other day, you know, and so, no, when you, you know, when you have had the, shall I say, just the chance, you know, to meet all these people and you see them on TV and, you know, and they doing their thing, you know, look at Adrian. Adrian was maybe about 8 years old when I first saw him, you know, and Rashid Warren. So, you know, it's I'm having fun, man. You know, it's been a blessing, man, yeah. The whole ride. You know, the good, the bad, and the ugly.
Yeah, one more thing. How important is it for fighters to not only do what they do inside the ring, but truly understand the business, or have somebody that you trust to put you in the business? I want you to say, put you in a business mode that you can be able to have trust in them.
It's very crucial, right? Because, you know, a lot of people, you know, this was a conversation also come through this sport. And you may see a Lamont Peterson or you may see an Adrian or Floyd or whomever on TV, and the networks will tell you how much they got paid, or, you know, you may see them in a commercial or, you know, whatever, you know, and you say, okay, well, you know, I know these guys, I can do that. But it's not that easy, you know. You look at the coaches, same thing, it's not that easy. All these people that you see, 99.9% of them put real work in, you know, and I think the thing that, you know, kind of made us take a step back in the sport, you know, when people start seeing that, it was no longer about the passion, it was no longer about the love, it was no longer about the grind, it was all about finance. And you got, you know, somebody may come along and say, well, okay, you know, stay in your gym 15, 20 minutes, learn a little boxing language, you know, get into a kid's ear. Next thing you know, you take them out there, you don't teach them, and you put them on that stage. You know, not because they had the gift or they were good enough, but because you see dollar signs of money. It was never about that with us. You know, I mean, you go back and you talk to somebody like Nazem, or you talk to Virgil or Mike Stafford. You know, these guys took kids that they didn't have to take, spent their own money, spent their time. You know, they wasn't into it for no, you know, finances. They generally, you know, genuinely loved the kids.
Yeah,
and they put the work in.
Even those names that you named, I can see the passion when Virgil Hunter talks to his fighter. It's nothing about a paycheck. He's trying to get that fighter where he needs to be as a fighter.
Right.
You know, yeah. Because the pay comes with that. So won't you just concentrate on the boxing side?
That's if you are that guy. That's if you are someone with that passion and love for the athlete and love for the sport. If you're that guy, then that's what's going to happen. Mm-hmm. But if you somebody that's coming in here just to get a paycheck or just to get a dime, you know what I mean? This sport not for you. And to me, those are the ones that really crush the sport, man.
Yeah. There you go, Barry Hunter. Thanks, Barry.
You got it.